Il est largement démontré que les problèmes environnementaux sont
une facteur de conflit. Même s'il est évident qu'ils ne sont pas la seule cause, although they might not be the only cause, they can be the source or they can exacerbate tensions which pre-existed, leading to stressful or desperate situations which then will fuel competition for natural resources. But the rivalry does not happen only in precarious situations, but also due to the fact that there are abundant resources, there is then a competition for their exploitation. These situations have suggested that cooperation in the protection of biodiversity could be an efficient way to decrease conflicts and promote a peaceful general culture, which led to the emergence of the Parks for Peace. Environment was a source of conflict, and this led to original initiatives, for instance, such as the proposal for the ecocide offense. Parks for the Peace are an idea for protected areas. As protected areas, these parks will have an obvious objective of preservation and conservation of biodiversity. As cross-border areas, the objective will be pursued with a cooperation between at least two states or subnational authorities, and as parks for the peace, these areas are obviously trying to achieve a peace objective. Transporter conservation is important. First of all, it allows to adopt an integrated and adaptive management of biodiversity on the scale of ecosystems in order to preserve ecologic processes and evolutionary processes that created biodiversity so that ecosystems will be dealt with holistically. And also, transporter, cross-border conservation ensures that cultural integrity is preserved. By going through borders, trans-border areas will go through borders which have been sometimes politically decided without taking into consideration the preservation of indigenous knowledge and social networks. These parks allow international tourists to have free access to an eco-region, providing opportunities for investment and possibly a better redistribution of ecotourism through promotion. By connecting biodiversity conservation with maintenance of social networks and social links and the creation of lasting livelihood means, this may consolidate peace either by preventing the appearance of conflicts which directly are linked with a rivalry for the environment between countries who otherwise have good relationship, or initiating a dialogue between two countries who used to be in conflict. Peace is therefore considered in the wide meaning and positive meaning, leading to benefits which naturally come from a healthy environment, a lasting economic development and fair social justice. This reminds us of environmental justice, which integrates social environmental justice, better distribution of benefits and constraints for the environment between populations, racial, social, ethnic populations within ecologic justice, a better division of environmental elements between the environment and man. This relationship shows, highlights the fact that benefiting from environmental resources and benefits and services for all requires that the systems which support life are maintained. The justification, therefore, for these parks for peace require that biodiversity is a shared value. Its conservation is therefore important for cooperation and a way for cooperation to take place. And the same goes for ecocide. Ecocide is something where biodiversity translates into a life support for all kinds of life, including mankind life. An ecocide is a crime destroying an ecosystem by overexploiting it in order to meet some needs for other processes and systems. The word is coined from ecosystem and genocide because it symbolizes destruction or irreversible damage done to an ecosystem, except that the destruction is not necessarily intentional. Several historical examples of human action leading to the disruption of ecosystem balances can may be mentioned. We can talk about the drying out of the Sea of Aral due to excessive use of water from the rivers constituting the sea, leading to hydrological, climatic and social consequences with the loss of fisheries, agriculture and the appearance of diseases. This term is coined to refer to behavior that attack and damage the environment as a life-supporting environment, measuring social, ecological, political, and economic consequences. Ecocide is a term referring to a crime which has been discussed for many years now. It was included and then removed from the various legislation documents regarding crimes against peace, and it is now contemplated to amend the statutes of the International Court of Justice in order to widen its competence and to allow to sue individual people with the principle of hierarchical superiority when they have committed a crime against the ecosystem, albeit unintentionally. Heads of government and company managers, financial institutions, or even environmental expertise companies could be involved because the project means that people who are complicit to an ecocide could also be considered as liable to prosecution. The crime against the environment would become the fifth crime, a crime against mankind, war crime and aggression crime being the other four. In 2013, a project was released, but the European Commission has not yet examined it, and the Brussels Charter from 2014 is thinking of creating a penal court for crimes against the environment and health. Ecocide would therefore be a crime created to make states and international companies more responsible regarding their behavior against the ecosystem, leading to better environmental justice.